Many of whom have trekked from all corners of the city to the Community Tenants Association. Thank you very much, Mr. Leung. Thank you to all the members of CTA. Don't be shy. Don't be a quiet. To our friends at TUTU, the Council of Community Housing Organization, thank you for your leadership. To all the students from the San Francisco International School, thank you for being here and getting the word out. To my former colleague and our former state assembly person representing this part of San Francisco, Tom Amiano, thank you for joining us today. To all the folks and the leadership from the Harvey Milk Democratic Club who's out there right now hanging door hangers as we speak, thanks for joining us. To my former colleagues on the Democratic County Central Committee, Rafael Mandelman, Commissioner Petra Davies-Zood, thank you for being here. I think this is a turning point in politics. It can lead on affordable housing, on keeping San Francisco a diverse city that is for everybody. And it's been a pretty great week at City Hall. Not only are we advancing Proposition C to build more affordable housing in San Francisco, but this is the week where finally, after a decade, San Francisco has filed a lawsuit against the Academy of Arts to return hundreds of units of affordable housing that were taken off the market. So we not only have to build more, which is what Proposition C is about, but we have to preserve and retain the affordable housing stock that we have.
Yes.
We will be joined shortly by the chief sponsor of Proposition C, my colleague, Supervisor Jane Kim,
woo!
Who is off at another rally. And I have to say, we have been hitting districts all over the city. Sandy Feuer and her team have walked District 1. District 5 has been walked. Today, we are going to hit District 8, a critical district with a high voter turnout. And one of our early sponsors, co-sponsors of this measure, is my colleague, Supervisor David Campos. Supervisor Campos, please come on up here. Sandy Feuer.
Thank you, Supervisor Peskin. Welcome to La Misión. Welcome to the mission, everyone. It's a very important time in the history of this neighborhood and the city. And I think Prop C really goes to the heart of what has been the reason why so many San Franciscans have been pushed out, which is we have not made a priority of building affordable housing in the city and county of San Francisco. And with Prop C, what we have is the first real, meaningful, tangible effort to actually make sure that going forward, you cannot build in San Francisco unless you prioritize affordable housing for a working and middle class. Prop C is ultimately, when you think about how remarkable it is that we are doubling the inclusionary amount that is required now. And what that does is not only does it set a new floor, but it actually changes the conversation for all the different projects that are in the works. Because no longer are they saying, oh, well, you know, we do the minimum of 12%. You have to do 25%. And the expectation in places like the Mission is that if the minimum is actually just a beginning, that the minimum is precisely that, that the minimum is the minimum, and that we actually expect even a higher number. So I think that this is a very important piece of legislation, the fact that voters will have a chance to say yes on Prop C, I think will send a very clear message. And let's be honest, the reason why Prop C is on the ballot with Aaron Peskin and Dame Kim is for the same reason that we are seeing the Board of Supervisors taking action on homelessness, and we're going to have to see the Board of Supervisors take action on police reform. This mayor is an absentee mayor who hasn't done anything to address the real issues facing San Francisco. That's the bottom line, and that's why Prop C, at the end of the day, is about making sure that we have a city that actually belongs to all of us. So thank you so much. I'm proud to support this measure.
Thank you, Supervisor Martin. Thank you, Supervisor Campos, and I see that Building Inspector Commissioner Myrna Melgar has joined us.
Woo!
Thank you. And we will hear from her in just a few moments. Our incredible Planning Commissioner Cindy Wu is here.
Yeah.
And now it is my pleasure to bring up our colleague Supervisor Norman Yee. And Supervisor Yee played a critical role in getting this to the ballot. When we first introduced this, it was touch and go whether or not we would have the 6 votes to put this charter amendment before the voters of San Francisco. And Supervisor Yee was able to craft a resolution, the resolution that I call the Roadmap to Peace, that ultimately was able to get us an 11-0 vote to put Prop 3 on the ballot. Supervisor Norman Yee, come on up.
Thank you, Supervisor Peskin, my colleague and my hero and my... Never mind. Good morning, how are you? I got home on. I'm here really to be another person that's going to be supporting Prop C wholeheartedly. You notice that Supervisor Peskin did not say, oh, we walked District 7 also. Well, if anybody wants to join me next week, I'm going to cover every precinct in District 7. It's really important for not only people that are in this part of town that we have affordable housing for low and middle income families. It's important throughout San Francisco. We're already fighting that fight before Prop C with the Balboa Reservoir project. We're not satisfied with 12%. We're not satisfied with 25%. We won't be satisfied until we get 50%. That's where we're going to have our fight. So when we talk about Prop C, we're setting the bottom. We want projects to actually do better than that. Is that right? So I want all of you today to join us who have been doing this fight. Make sure you take a precinct. Make sure you get out there and pass out this literature to let people know that Prop C is a winner. Prop C in 2014 was the children's fund. Prop C, and we won like crazy because people like you walk the precincts. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Supervisor Dean. And I also want to say we could not have gotten this far without the help of the House of Labor. I want to salute Elizabeth Alexander and the SEIU 10-1. Thank you, Ms. Alexander, for all of the SEIU's support. And with that, it is my pleasure to bring our Planning Commissioner, Cindy Wu, up to say a few words.
I have people from neighborhoods come to us and say, give us the kind of neighborhoods that we want. Give us neighborhoods that have affordable housing. Give us neighborhoods that have stores that we need to go to. Give us neighborhoods that we want to live in. And we are so blessed to have the leadership to put Prop C on the ballot to give us the tools to do that. We are leading the nation. I was just visiting LA this last week. They don't have inclusionary housing at all. I think that everyone is looking to San Francisco to lead the nation to show how we can do better for our neighborhoods, how we can keep low-income people in our neighborhoods, how we can keep working-class people in our neighborhoods, how we can let people know that they have a sense of security, that they have a home, so that they can build their lives, build their communities, and stay for the long term. And so get out there today, drop the lit, get some tea. Great to see the coalition of everyone here. I'll be out there dropping lit with you. Woo!
And our colleague, Supervisor John Obelos, who's out of town this weekend, I want to give a shout out to Francis Shea from his office is here. Thanks for being back. So how many people here, oh, and Pratima Gupta, Dr. Gupta, thank you, Bruce Wolf, know somebody who lives in a BMR unit? Look at that. That is because since the year 2002, San Francisco, back when I served on the Board of Supervisors with Tom Amiano, has had an inclusionary housing program. And the stories are extraordinary. The woman who ran the Chameleon Cafe in my district on Russian Hill, Melanie Sue, and her family live in a BMR. The person that serves Ms. Flandrick and I coffee at the Cafe Trieste in the mornings lives in a BMR. The stories are incredible, and we are hanging on to the fabric of our neighborhoods because of these below market rate units. And somebody is here to tell you one of those stories, and it is my pleasure to invite Larry Richards up here, who
one of the fortunate few, my life was saved by affordable housing. A lot of you know me, but some of you don't. I've had major surgery in my abdomen. I've had cancer surgery in my thyroid. My caregiver saved my life. It's called in-home support services. The key to that is the word in-home. I was homeless. I had no care. But eventually, after 3 years, I got a BMR. I am only alive today because I had help. Oh, I know you see homeless people in the street every day, and they're in their sleeping bags and their tents, and they're all drug addicted, alcoholic losers, right? Come say that to me. I'll take you to 50 people I know on the streets right now in tents, in sleeping bags. One of them that I know, one of my good friends, had his eye bashed in. Oh. He was in the hospital. I've lost track of him, to be honest with you. Life in the streets is very hard. You can die very easily. My life was saved. I'm one of the fortunate few. Why do we have to even have this fight? When you go and look at yourself in the mirror in your home, why can't I look at myself in the mirror in another home? There's a $49,500,000 condominium in this town. I welcome the person, the family that buys that $50 million home because they're going to have to pay taxes on it. I welcome that person or that family. I'm not against them. I'm glad they've got the money to buy a $50 million home in San Francisco. But if a developer can build a $50 million home in San Francisco, can't they build $50 million homes? Or how about $500,000 home, so that people like me can have a place to live too. Do you think that's possible?
We're in a hurry, and I don't want to say anymore, but if you don't go out and support this proposition, somebody like me will die on the streets, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, maybe my friend. You gotta keep it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I know we all want to go out there and rock some precincts, but now it is my pleasure to introduce the sponsor of Proposition C, who has been a leader on affordable housing for all of her half a dozen years on the Board of Supervisors, the one and only Jane Kim.
Yay! And by the way, because I know many of you will have walking September and October of last year, thank you for helping us win Supervisor Aaron Peskin in the office. Double the requirement that we ask for luxury and market rate developers to build here in San Francisco. Their contribution to our affordable and middle income class households if we didn't have six votes to the Board of Supervisors this year. So this is about the long game. You're talking about the long game, and I'm so proud that we're going to be able to put this on the ballot and finally eliminate the ceiling that we asked about, that we put in place on developers and building affordable housing in San Francisco. That is what Proposition C is about. We are taking away that ceiling, and we are saying on top of that, we know you can do much more than the 15% that you did before. And on top of that, we don't just want you to build for working class households. We want you to build for the middle class households that are also being squeezed out in San Francisco, our nurses, our teachers, our entry-level office workers, our small business owners that also can't afford to live in the city that they love and that they work in today. And that is what Proposition C is about. Proposition C is about taking back our city. This is a city that we can not only work in and thrive in and volunteer in and be community leaders, but it's also the city that we get to live in as well. So thank you so much for coming out today. There is so much on stake at the June 7th ballot. The primary is often overlooked in our election, but we have Proposition C on the ballot that is going to help make the city more affordable for everyone, including Larry Richards, who spoke today. I met Larry my first year on the Board of Supervisors. I had office hours on 6th Street across from Rose Hotel, where he had been living and then had been evicted. Over the course of my entire 4 years on the Board of Supervisors, Larry was in and out of our shelter system, as he talked about. And it was on my election night in 2014 that he came to my victory party and showed me his keys to his new below-market rate condo in Rincon Hill. How amazing. That anyone has ever offered me in my time was when Larry told me that there was a woman-only sauna in his condo in Rincon Hill that he couldn't use, and he offered me an extra set of keys to his apartment building so that I could use it to relax. But there are real people that live in them, and they are saving lives here in San Francisco. They are saving people's lives, and that is why we are fighting for more of them this year. So on June 7th, we have yes on Proposition C. We also have a very important election about who is going to represent our local Democratic Party here in San Francisco. Is it going to be realtors?
No.
Or is it going to be the people of San Francisco? We want them to run their businesses here in San Francisco, but we don't want them to run San Francisco. And that is why the DCCC election is so important on June 7th. So Raphael Mendelman, President of City College Board of Trustees, is holding the beautiful blue Reform Democrat flyers that have him, Aaron Peskin, myself, Dr. Pratima Gupta, Francis Shea, Elizabeth Alexander, Cindy, Planning Commissioner Cindy Wu, Supervisor Norman Lee, Supervisor David Campos, and many others. Now, this is a labor of love because very few people actually want to run and go to these monthly long meetings at a cell phone reception at the state building. And Police Commissioner Pedro de Jesus and already called her Supervisor Sandra Stewart. This is also a very important race for June. If we can win this in June, we can win November. Again, it is about the long game. Supervisor Aaron Peskin winning in November, allowing us to put Proposition C on the ballot to double the requirement for inclusionary ballot, for inclusionary housing. We are going to win on June 7th. We are going to take back the Democratic Party, and we will have Sandra Fuhrer, Hillary Ronan, Kimberly Alvarado serving on the Board of Supervisors with us. There is a lot at stake at June 7th, so thank you for coming out today. Please come back every weekend. We need you every Saturday, because we are not going to have as much money or as much resources as the other side. So we are going to win because of people power. Thank you, Community Tennis Association, San Francisco Tennis Association, for being here today.
And all of you folks from the San Francisco International School are going to come downstairs, and all of you at the back of the room are going to come over here by the podium, and we're all going to turn around, and we are going to show in a photo just how much people power we have as we get ready to hit the streets. And then let me say this about that. The work that Supervisor Kim and our colleagues do could not be done without our incredible staff. April Veneracion from James King's office, Shelly Ann Gulo from our office, Tyler Chan, and Lee Hefner is back there somewhere. Thank you guys for all of your incredible work.
Just in contact with one of your juniors, you can find some.
Pay attention.
Yeah.
You need big smiles, okay?
Like I see you
are. The sign, you need big smiles. Hold the signs above your head.
Go Gola! Go Gola! Go Gola! Go Gola! Go Gola! Go Gola!
Over here.
Go Gola! Go Gola! Go Gola!
All right, here we go.
Okay,
big smile. Here we go.
Yeah.
One, two, three.